Dr. Lee, William McKinley Jeffries wrote a book, Safe Uses of Cortisol, and he talked about the importance of a bioidentical cortisol to stabilize the adrenals. And then later, Dr. Wilson wrote Adrenal Fatigue and talked about certain herbs and nutraceuticals and ways to stabilize with lifestyle and supplements. So is it possible that the Endocrinological Society at some point will catch up to where you're at? I mean, the data is quite clear, isn't it?
Well, I think maybe 20 years from now, they'll say adrenal fatigue does exist, but currently it's ridiculed and it's not accepted. But I think the younger generation of doctors coming out, I think they'll be more receptive. And I had adrenal fatigue starting my new practice.
Wow.
And my cortisols were flatlined.
Yeah.
And the thing is that a lot of people have adrenal fatigue. And it's not, they're so relieved when they come to see me because it's not in their heads. It's not in their mind. They're not imagining, you know, fatigueness. I can't get up.
Right.
So, you know, I try to use everything. And then if things don't work, then I'll use basically our Cortef to help.
Which is hydrocortisone.
Exactly.
At low dose, yeah. Mm-hmm. And the intervals support, the body produces at least 40 milligrams a day on its own, right?
Exactly.
And anything less than that and the body is starting to fail. It was once stated that it's one of the hormones that you can't live without. It's the front line of defense. It protects you from various stress problems. But people blame it. They think that cortisol production is the bad guy when it's present to protect you, and then they thought it was the one that was the one causing harm. Is that probably true?
Well, I think, cortisol is also involved with it's your energy. I mean, I call it the fuel. And when you have low fuel, like if you drive a car and you don't fill up the car with gasoline, you're not going to go far. So you need to fill up that gas tank. And the two things that I naturally, what I tell my patients that can get your cortisol up is you got to sleep. It's not just the quantity, it's also the quality. And so I'm really impressed when they have sleep apnea, you get that corrected, their energy is phenomenal.
Yeah.
So I really try to focus, the first thing is sleep, sleep, sleep. If you sleep well, everything generally gets better.
And there's probably some evidence about not necessarily just 8 hours of sleep, but maybe getting to bed earlier, sunrise, sunset.
Exactly.
Isn't the body more conditioned to those biorhythms and it's more consistent?
You're exactly right. Biorhythms is, nature does it. If you go against nature, you'll lose.